We're joined by a woman who goes by the name of Syrian Girl. And I've seen her videos on YouTube where she's been interviewed by some other journalists and people. And she wants to be private, and where she's not private, but she's 100% Syrian and has family that she can report on what's happening. But she does want to be private, so that'll just pique everybody's interest exactly who she is. But she'll go by Syrian Girl. And she joins us now. Recap the point you make about Al Qaeda. I just had Lieutenant Colonel Anthony Schaefer, who ran the Bin Laden program trying to kill him, who was blocked from killing him, pointing out that Anwar al-Awlaki, who's run all the big terror attacks in the U.S., is really a Pentagon double agent, White House agent. Now, that's Colonel Schaefer. You'd think that'd be big news. So break down your view of what's happening. Break down the view in Syria of what people think about Qaeda.
Okay, so in Syria, everybody knows that Al-Qaeda is the CIA. It's really, really common knowledge, you know. You can ask any kid on the street and he'll tell you that. So, it's not really like what you just said, though I haven't heard about it. It doesn't surprise me at all, because there's just so much information out there already of people that turned out to be double agents that, you know, were captured and supposed to be part of Al-Qaeda. So,
yeah, go over that, because I've seen you. You have a great knowledge of it, the history of it, so some of the examples of proving it's Al-Qaeda.
First of all, you have the one of the Libyan rebel leaders. Turns out he was tortured in Guantanamo Bay, and he's part of Al-Qaeda, and we all know that NATO and the U.S., you know, they supported the Libyan rebels. So they're one of the big signs now, which is what I mentioned in my video, is that they're actually working with Al-Qaeda in these countries that we're seeing insurgency. So Libya was one of them. And in Syria, also, there are videos now coming out of some of the protesters and some of the people in the so-called Free Syrian Army, which is what the insurgents, the name they give themselves, carrying Al-Qaeda flags. And these are like widely available on YouTube. You can just search for it and it's there. If I can go on, another big indicator would be Al Jazeera, who since the very beginning was the only station that was able to get videos of Osama bin Laden giving speeches, and was the only one that was able to play them or desired to play them. And, you know, whenever we heard about Al-Qaeda, it was always from Al Jazeera. You know, they're here, they're there. It was a thing that was promoting them. And who controls Al Jazeera? Well, Qatar. You know, it's Qatar State TV.
Who's sending special forces everywhere to try to overthrow Libya? You name it, bringing in Al Qaeda. You're pointing out, that's why Gaddafi knew to try to jam Al Jazeera, because they were beaming in pro-war stuff. It's so obvious.
Yeah, it's very obvious, and it was obvious from the very, very beginning, like 8 years ago, or maybe it was more than 8 years ago, when Al Jazeera was even started. You could tell by the way they reported things.
It's total British intelligence, the whole thing.
Yeah, pretty much. Either US or British, you know, it doesn't really matter, because they're all one entity working, you know, together. Israel and the country Qatar, they're allies. The US, you know, they control each other, so it's like one big monster.
That's right. Continuing with Al-Qaeda examples from the Syrian perspective.
You know, it's, you, when you're on the spot, it's difficult to think of them. It's just so many. This is maybe not an Al-Qaeda example, but it's a very important example of false flag operations. I'm not sure if anybody remembers, but in Iraq, in Basra, two British soldiers, like special forces soldiers, were captured dressed up as Arabs, shooting at Iraqi police which was by then under the control of the occupation. And they were dressed in black to mimic sort of like the Mehdi army. And their car was filled with explosives. This was all over the news. And the British army were, you know, the British leadership were so panicked about it that they sent the army in to destroy and level the entire police station. This is a police station that was allied with them to get these men out, and they did. But you can imagine what they knew and what they were doing. Just as Arabs attacking their supposed allies.